Hi friends, welcome back to IGMA script series. So in this video we are going to discuss about the template strings, or you can say the template literal, right? So basically there is some methods, or you can say some rules, to handle the string inside the IGMA script. So let's take an example and to clear it more. So basically when we'll discuss about the IGMA script, we'll always discuss with the JavaScript, we'll always relate both things, all right? So that we can understand what is the basic difference between the JavaScript and IGMA script. So let's take a variable, suppose let name, and last day we have discussed about what is let, what is the var, and what is the difference between these two things, and what is the constant. So if you don't see this video, please see from my playlist, the links are provided in the description section. Suppose the name is Shomo, that's my name Shomo, and if you want to print these things, suppose I just consoling these things, so write console.log and simply write here the variable name, right? And if you just go in the browser and refresh this, sorry, you need to open the console. So just console, and we can see the name is printed, right? So that is okay. Now if I want to print these things with the strings, suppose here I just want to write my name is something, that is plus name. So to concatenate we need to use the plus, and to print the string we need to use either single inverted comma or double inverted comma, okay? So now just check, so we can see the output, my name is Shomo. So this is the simple JavaScript. So what is new in the IGMA script? The thing is, IGMA script does this thing very easily. They resolve the conflict between single inverted comma or double inverted comma. So let's see how we can print these same things into the IGMA script. So just comment out these things, and let's copy this thing and paste it here. So this is not a proper way. So to print any value with the string, we need to use the backtick, right? In this way, we need to use the backtick, and this is the variable that is name. So how we can use this? Simply just use the dollar and curly braces. So inside this curly braces we can write the variable. So if you check again, you can see this is the same output. That means the previous one and this one the same output, but the difference in the syntax. And basically this will solve the double inverted and single inverted comma confliction. Sometimes if we start with single inverted comma and then we just write the double inverted comma, sometimes confliction, but all confliction resolves. Now we are using the backtick sign. Suppose you want to add some more string, suppose let email, right? And if you just write this email, suppose my email, that is Shomo webwork@email.com, and if you just print with these things. So for simple JavaScript, how to do this? So another plus, then space inside here, and let's print the email, and here just write, and my email is this, right? So this is the way. But for the ES6, that is the IGMA script, how we can write this? Simply just write in this way, and my email is, and let's take the variable. So how to do this? So add the rate, then curly braces, open close, and email. So basically this will give the same outputs. Sorry, the add rate, why not? Sorry, there will not be add the rate, there will be dollar, right? So my mistake. So let's refresh this so we can get, right? So this is very easy. And if you take some another thing, so let's handle these things with some number. So simply write let number 1, so I'm taking two numbers, that's number 1 equal to 10, and let's use any sum operation. So let's num 2 equal to suppose 20. Now how to do this? So simple, console dot log, and just write any string, the sum is, and here we need to write in this way. So add a plus num 1 plus num 2, better if you just write these things into the brackets, right? So it will give the output 10 plus 20 equal to 30. Okay, good. And now if I want to print the same things inside the ECMA script, so simply write console dot log and just copy this thing. So just write here with the backtick, right? And simply, so now instead of 30, just write dollar, and let's open and close the curly braces, then num1 plus num2. So how easy is that? So just refresh this, the sum is 30. Okay, so actually this is the small example. That's a reason you are thinking what is the difference and how it looks like easy. But in the large case, when you are actually developing, and if you just habituate with this syntax, you can use this easily. Actually, if you just use for long string or some long text, that time there may have confusion with these things. You can understand as a developer, if you previously use these things, you can understand how these things getting problem. But this time ECMAScript solves this problem. So this is a simple tutorial and all was the easy things. So next day we are going to discuss about the function. So we'll discuss about functions in ECMAScript. Okay, so please comment if you have any queries about this video, and please like and subscribe this channel for upcoming videos. So each day I am going to publish a video on this topic and will complete this series. So thanks for watching this video. Have a good day.